Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Safriya Palace today the Ambassador of the Arab Republic of Egypt to the Kingdom of Bahrain, Suha Ibrahim Muhammad Rifat, who presented to His Majesty the King a written letter from the President of Egypt, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. The letter was an invitation for His Majesty the King to attend the Second World Youth Forum, which will be held in Alexandria next November. His Majesty the King expressed thanks for the invitation and commended the strong Bahraini-Egyptian relations and the development of joint cooperation between the two countries in all fields. His Majesty also praised the pioneering role and contributions of Egypt in enriching human civilizations through consolidating the values of peace, communication, and dialogue between various people and cultures. His Majesty the King also highlighted the vital role of youth in building the development of their countries and achieving their sustainable development goals. He stressed the importance of supporting youth with education to help them carry out their duties and ensure the development of their countries. His Majesty wished the upcoming World Youth Forum success in achieving its desired goals in serving youth and realizing their inspirations. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Safriya Palace the chairman of the Jafri Endowments, Mohsen bin Al Sheikh Abd Mohsen Khalaf Al Usfur, and a number of heads of matams to greet His Majesty on the occasion of the conclusion of Ashura season. The guests expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for his directives to various government authorities to provide all services and facilitations for the occasion. His Majesty the King affirmed his keenness in providing all potentialities. He asserted that the people of Bahrain are trustworthy and are a source of pride. His Majesty expressed appreciation for Ashura season, expressing aspirations for achieving the best for all. His Majesty also expressed thanks and appreciation to all ministries and concerned institutions, mainly the Ministry of Interior, with all its departments for their efforts, facilitations, and security and community services aimed at protecting citizens and residents. His Majesty noted that Bahrain has been distinguished throughout history by a civilized society, where the principles of religious pluralism, tolerance, and coexistence are established. He affirmed that preserving these levels of religious freedom is a joint responsibility. The chairman of the Jafari Endowment delivered a speech in which he expressed appreciation and gratitude to His Majesty the King for his support to revive the Ashura season anniversary in the kingdom. He hailed His Majesty's speech, which reflects His Majesty's wisdom and perseverance to overcome all challenges. He said that the speech of His Majesty the King has comforted the people of Bahrain, adding that the government has always been keen to respect the rituals of Ashura season and will always remain this way. He recalled with appreciation the noble directives of the late Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa regarding the protection of the right to worship. He stressed the need to prevent the violations committed by a group of people that is supposed or supported by suspicious foreign bodies to harm the national unity of Bahrain. Al Usfur also values the facilitations and services provided by the Ministry of Interior, led by the Minister of Interior, Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, to establish security and ensure the success of the Ashura season. He stated that the Jafari Endowments has started preparing for Ashura 2018 early, where it held meetings with various relative bodies, including matams, Husseiniyah processions, as well as governmental bodies, to set an integrated plan to ensure the success of the season. He wished His Majesty the King abundant health and success and the Bahraini people further progress and prosperity.
Thank you. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، حبيبنا المصطفى الأمين وعترته الطيبين الطاهرين وصحابته المنتجبين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى قيام يوم الدين. حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى، أصحاب السمو والمعالي، الأخوة الأعزاء الحضور، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. صاحب الجلالة، يطيب لي بالأصالة عن نفسي ونيابة عن جميع أعضاء مجلس الأوقاف الجعفرية وموظفي الإدارة ومنتسبيها ورؤساء إدارات المآتم والمواكب والمضائف الحسينية في مملكة البحرين أن نرفع إلى مقام جلالتكم السامي أسمى آيات التقدير والامتنان والشكر والعرفان على ما تولونه جلالتكم حفظكم الله من رعاية واهتمام بمراسيم إحياء ذكرى عاشوراء السنوية في مملكتنا الغالية في إطار من الوحدة الوطنية والتعايش وفي ظل روح الأسرة الواحدة. كما ننتهز هذه الفرصة لنثمن المضامين العظيمة التي تضمنها الخطاب الملكي السامي لجلالتكم، والذي يعكس ما تتمتعون به حفظكم الله من حكمة عالية وإرادة صلبة لقيادة سفينة الوطن بكفاءة واقتدار وتجاوز كافة التحديات بسعة الصدر والتحلي بالأخلاق الإسلامية السمحة والشيم العربية الأصيلة. ولقد بعثت الكلمة السامية لجلالتكم بشائر الفرحة والارتياح لدى عموم شعب البحرين، وأنه ليس غريباً على جلالتكم هذه اللفتة الكريمة السامية، فلطالما أكدتم مراراً وتكراراً وأنه ليس غريباً على أن تحظى شعائر يوم عاشوراء ومراسم إحيائها في كل عام بالتقدير والاحترام والرعاية والاهتمام، وهي خصوصية تاريخية كانت تنفرد بها مملكة البحرين بين الدول الإسلامية، ولا زالت حتى يومنا هذا وستبقى كذلك إن شاء الله تعالى. ولا غرو في ذلك، فنهج جلالتكم هو امتداد لشمائل أجدادكم حكام آل خليفة الكرام كابراً عن كابر، وليس أدل من ذلك على استحضاركم لوصية والدكم المغفور له بإذن الله تعالى صاحب العظمة الشيخ عيسى بن سلمان آل خليفة رحمه الله في رعاية حقوق البلاد والعباد وما تضمنته من معان إنسانية نبيلة وحقوقية راقية في العدالة والإنصاف والتسامح وجمع الكلمة. كما نشاطر جلالتكم التوجيه السامي لأهمية الحفاظ على قدسية هذه المناسبات التي يزخر بها تاريخ مملكتنا العريق وخصوصيتها الدينية وما ترسخه من قيم خيرة مثالية ومعان سامية، وضرورة استثمارها لتوثيق عرى الإخاء بين جميع أبناء مملكة البحرين تحت راية وحدتهم الوطنية وقيمهم الإسلامية، مشددين على ضرورة تجنب تكرار ما حدث من تجاوز أثيم من فئة شاذة مغرر بها مدعومة من جهات مشبوهة من الخارج تهدف للإضرار بالوحدة الوطنية وتلاحم الشعب حول مليكهم، والتي كان وعي شعب البحرين لها بالمرصاد وسيظل الحارس الأمين لإفشال كل ما يحاك ويدبر ضده وضد قيادته. كما نثمن عالياً توجيهات جلالتكم الدائمة ومتابعتكم الشخصية لكافة شؤون الموسم، منوهين بالجهود الكبيرة والمساعي الطيبة والخدمات الجليلة المقدمة من كافة وزارات الدولة ومؤسساتها، وعلى الأخص جهود وزارة الداخلية بكافة إداراتها لإنجاح هذه المناسبة بإشراف مباشر من وزير الداخلية معالي الفريق الركن الشيخ راشد بن عبد الله آل خليفة لبسط أجواء الأمن وتأمين حضور المشاركين في إحياء هذه المناسبة وإنجاح مبادرة النقل الجماعي المجاني للمعزين وغيرها. صاحب الجلالة، إن إدارة الأوقاف الجعفرية بدأت استعداداتها المبكرة لتنظيم موسم عاشوراء لعام 1440 هجرية الموافق ل 2018، حيث وضعت خطة متكاملة لضمان نجاح هذا الموسم وإحيائه على أكمل وجه، وعقدت للمرة الأولى اجتماعات مركزية تنسيقية مع جميع المآتم والحسينيات والمواكب وهيئات العزاء والمضائف الحسينية من جميع مناطق مملكة البحرين، بمشاركة ممثلي جميع الجهات الحكومية ذات الصلة، كما قامت بتطوير منظومة متكاملة من الخدمات لتوزيع المكرمة الملكية السامية تغطي ما يربو على 600 ماتم و135 موكباً و15 هيئة عزاء مركزية و750 مضيفاً. وختاماً لا يسعنا إلا أن نسأل العلي القدير أن يمتع جلالتكم بموفور الصحة والسعادة وطول العمر، راجين من الله تبارك وتعالى أن يعود هذه المناسبات على جلالتكم وعلى شعب البحرين الكريم بالعزة والمنعة، ودمتم يا صاحب الجلالة بعون الله سالمين محفوظين موفقين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa at the Ghudaybiyah Palace today. They reviewed the efforts being exerted by the government to enhance the quality of services delivered to the citizens so as to appeal to them and achieve the government's aspirations in this regard. They stressed that coordination among ministries and the implementation of the principle of complementary action among them have an effect role in expediting citizen-oriented government projects and ensuring their completion according to schedule, as well as in consolidating the kingdom's investment atmosphere and spurring economic activities. While reviewing regional developments, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince highlighted the importance of visits between officials of the Gulf Cooperation Council, the GCC countries, which agree on the need to achieve common interests and increase coordination among them to achieve the common interests of the region's countries and enhance their development process. In this regard, His Royal Highness the Premier and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince lauded the role played by Saudi Arabia in enhancing joint GCC and Arab action to ensure that it is on the right path towards protecting the interests of the region and its people. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa chaired the cabinet meeting today at Ghudaybiyah Palace in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister affirmed the government's keenness on continuing services development in various cities and villages and on continuing their urban planning. On the occasion of World Habitat Day, the cabinet noted the kingdom's achievements in the field of sustainable development in the era of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, asserting the government's approach of making further initiatives that enhance the quality of life and that contribute to forming a modern and comprehensive vision for cities and villages. His Royal Highness directed to continue the efforts that ensure providing the best services for seniors in recognition for their role in building the country. On the occasion of the International Day of Older Persons, His Royal Highness affirmed the government's appreciation and pride in seniors' efforts and their effective contributions to the kingdom. The cabinet expressed deep condolences to Indonesia over the earthquake and to tsunami victims, expressing the kingdom's support to Indonesia and wishing it success in overcoming the consequences of their crisis. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister directed the High Committee for Urban Planning, chaired by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister, to allocate a land for the new health center in Bidaya. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister directed to develop new initiatives to attract citizens to decent jobs in the private sector and to enhance coordination with this sector to produce training programs that grant the speedy employment of citizens according to their qualifications. The cabinet was briefed on developing employment rate in the private sector due to the stability of the new market and investments. The cabinet was also briefed by the Minister of Labour and Social Development on the most important indicators that characterize the first half of the year 2018. In implementation of the directives of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to follow up on the needs of villages and cities in terms of facilities and sports and youth activities, the Cabinet reviewed what has been achieved in this regard, including the establishment of new facilities, sports fields and youth centers in Galali, Umm al-Hasam, Al-Hawra, Al-Zallag, Al-Draz, Sitra, Bani Jamra, Al-Ghraya and Askar. The Cabinet followed up on the procedures taken by ministries and governmental bodies regarding the rationalization of expenditure, where the Minister of Water and Electricity submitted a report in this regard. These efforts resulted in improving performance and reducing expenditure by 46% as a result of several initiatives, including using online bills and using power-saving lamps. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister commended the efforts of the Minister of Water and Electricity as well as the ministry's affiliates, which resulted in this outcome. The Cabinet approved a Memorandum of Understanding in the field of cloud computing presented by the Minister of Interior between Bahrain, represented by the Information and E-Government Authority, and Kuwait, represented by the Communication and Information Technology Regulatory Authority. The Cabinet discussed Bahrain's accession to the International Solar Alliance. The Cabinet was briefed on the results of implementing the decision banning workers from working in open areas at noon in summer. The Minister of Labour and Social Development presented a report which showed that the Ministry has paid 10,300 inspection visits to 1,241 establishments, 98.5% of which have complied with the ban decision. The Cabinet was briefed by the Minister of Health on the procedures of making a comprehensive study in cooperation with the World Health Organization on pollution. The Cabinet referred two draft laws to the Representatives' Council, one amending municipalities' law and the second amending the law of collecting costs of establishing and developing infrastructure in reconstruction areas. The chairman of the committee of the Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa Award for Sustainable Development, His Highness Sheikh Hussam bin Isa Al Khalifa, has declared that former UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon has been selected as the winner of the prestigious 2018 award in recognition of his exemplary role in serving humanity, furthering peace efforts and leading to the formulation and adoption of the Sustainable Development Goals. This came during the work of the Bahrain Forum titled Joint Visions for a Successful Future, organized by the Kingdom on the sidelines of the 73rd session of the United Nations General Assembly. More in this report.
On behalf of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, Sheikh Hassan bin Isa Al Khalifa expressed his sincere congratulations to Mr. Ban Ki-moon for winning the award, which comes in recognition of his efforts to the formulation of a vision for future development that meets people's aspirations of further progress and prosperity. Sheikh Hassan bin Isa expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister for his initiatives that support the efforts aimed at the development of societies and achievement of security, peace, and coexistence among people.
Honored to correspond this award in his former, the former Secretary General of the United Nations, Mr. Ban Ki-moon.
He explained that the organizing committee of the award made their decision after careful consideration of finding no other candidate able to match his extraordinary accomplishments. The committee fully recognized Mr. Ban Ki-moon's remarkable life of service in his country, the Friendly Republic of South Korea, or in particular at the United Nations. He pointed to the increasing importance that the award has gained as one of the important international initiatives which reflects the keenness of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to support and sponsor every effort aimed at serving humanity and achieving sustainable development goals. He also said the award reflects the policy of Bahrain, which is keen on participating in the efforts of the international community in the field of sustainable development for a world where its people live in stability and prosperity in light of the challenges and tragedies experienced by many regions of the world.
The Royal Guard Special Force Commander, Major His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received today at Isa Air Base a number of participants in the Special Duty Force of the Bahrain Defense Force, the BDF, participating in the Restoring Hope Operation in Yemen within the Arab Coalition led by the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. His Highness welcomed the Special Duty Force participants and expressed thanks and appreciation for their efforts and dedication in performing their national duty within the Arab Coalition forces supporting the legitimacy in Yemen, led by Saudi Arabia's armed forces. He praised their noble sacrifices while participating alongside their brothers in restoring the legitimacy in Yemen. His Highness Sheikh Khalid handed over appreciation medals to a number of officers given by His Majesty the King in appreciation of their national efforts, professionalism, and discipline to carry out their noble mission. The reception was attended by a number of senior BDF officials and the families of the Special Duty Force participants. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa deputized Sheikh Khalifa bin Rashid Al Khalifa and President of Bahrain's Basketball Association Sheikh Isa bin Ali bin Khalifa yesterday to attend the ceremony that was held this evening by China's ambassador to the kingdom, Mr. Anwar Habiballah, at the Diplomat Hotel, marking China's National Day. A number of members of the diplomatic corps to the kingdom and guests attended the event. Sheikh Khalifa bin Rashid Al Khalifa and Sheikh Isa bin Ali bin Khalifa conveyed the greetings of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to the Chinese leadership and people on this occasion, wishing the friendly country further development. They also asserted the solid Bahraini-Chinese relations in all fields, noting the kingdom's keenness on bolstering joint cooperation that can meet both countries and their people's aspirations. For his part, the Chinese ambassador expressed his thanks and appreciation for His Royal Highness the Prime Minister's keenness on the distinguished development bilateral ties and highlighting Bahrain's development in all sectors. The Minister of Oil, Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, inaugurated the 17th Middle East Corrosion Conference and Exhibition held yesterday at the Bahrain International Exhibition and Convention Center, with various participations of engineers and specialists in the fields of corrosion and water treatment. The minister said the Corrosion Conference series aims to provide and exchange information for those interested in all areas of prevention and control of the phenomenon of corrosion in the oil, gas, energy, and various industries throughout the world. He noted since the launch of the conference's series in 1979, the event has gained a reputation among global events given the positive role in providing the best modern technologies in the field of oil, exploration, energy, corrosion, water treatment, researchers, and specialists in this vital field. Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa then opened the accompanying exhibition, which was attended by 73 companies from 29 local, regional, and international countries, which presented the latest findings of technologies in this field. As he toured the exhibition, the minister was briefed on the work of international companies specializing in this field and noted the importance of these participations and meetings to prepare national competencies and sharpen their skills, as well as to enhance the role of investments in this aspect.
An important topic. This conference has been going on for 40 years now. The topic of corrosion is very important for the oil and gas industry. Pipelines are the veins of the industry, and with time, oil, gas, they have more components that are corrosive. H2S, saline water, CO2, all of these add and contribute to the increased corrosion of pipes. And so to maintain the quality and integrity of the pipes, of the equipment, of the plants, it's very important for conferences like these to share the latest technology, latest practices. And you know, we have the largest companies in the region, of course, with Saudi Aramco participating. We have Babco, GPIC, Vanagas, all of them taking large interest in this topic. And I think we have to thank the event organizers for setting up an amazing conference and exhibition.
We have lots of petrochemical, oil, plants, industrial plants. They are all made out of metal, as we know, and they still face corrosion problems. Corrosion problems worldwide has not been solved 100%. But we still need to manage it, protect our equipment, protect the jobs, and protect lives, because the corrosion problem cost the world billions and billions of dollars. So without such studies, without the management of corrosion problem, we will not be in a position to have full control of this problem in order to reach to a stage where we will be able to 100% resolve it, but it will take some time. That's why there is a need to have such important gathering, such important conference, which will act as a major event for all specialized engineers.
This conference promotes the awareness about the need to control corrosion, what are the best practices that people can learn from each other. It brings in people and expertise from all around the globe to this area. It also promotes the development of our most precious resource, which is our engineers, our human resources. And this platform is also a platform for different technology providers to promote their new technologies and applications for mitigating corrosion. And it also add to our portfolio of international presence with our own contribution of experiences and our own reflections on the growth and also the advancement of our discipline with the high profile cases that we present and the knowledge sharing platforms that we have established in this conference.
The 17th Middle East conference and exhibition comes at a critical time in the history of both Bahrain and the Middle East, and in particular the Gulf Cooperation Council. The reason for that is that, especially with the investment that are coming, it's very important that we capitalize on all the issues that affects safety of the people, safety of the equipment, and profitability. It is for that particular reason that networking with the best brains in the world, in addition to exchanging best practices and learning with the different technologies, is what will continue to keep Babco amongst the best pace setters in the world. And this is, of course, a true translation to the meaning of sustainable development and according to the directives of the wise leadership and under the patronage of His Excellency Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa.